All right, first one today is from Owen. He says, I saw the Avengers Endgame TV spot during the big game, and despite it being the most excitement all night, come on, that game was pretty boring, I began to worry a little. Even though we might find it awesome that it shows nothing, is it showing enough to get the general audience interested despite the ending of
Infinity War.
Excuse me. I can't help but feel that they'll just think it's 3 hours of superheroes being sad since there's literally no action in any of the footage thus far. Thanks.
Yeah, so they did play it. By the way, I think they'll maybe play a spot around the Super Bowl. I don't think they'll play an endgame spot during the Super Bowl. And technically speaking, they played that spot before the kickoff. So I was right. I haven't been right a lot lately, so I got to take the wins where I can get them, folks. But anyway, they played that spot. And that point, Ray can attest to this. We had a bunch of friends over watching the Super Bowl yesterday. And in that point, when you see Captain America tightening the shield around his arm, I screamed like a little kid, he's got his fucking shield. Like, I was so excited and so pumped for it. And I think there's some very interesting things in the trailer. We'll talk about that in a second. I want to go back to one of the things you were saying. Was this really an effective trailer? Well, here's some anecdotal stuff. I was driving. It's rainy in LA today. The traffic's always slow, so it took me longer than normal to get to the studio this morning. So I had a chance to actually get around to listening to like three of my podcasts that I listen to. A couple of sports podcasts, and one was a news talk radio podcast. And in all of them, they talked about the Super Bowl commercials and their favorites. You know, the ESPN one talked about their top five favorites. Interesting. Remember, these aren't movie podcasts. These aren't hardcore MCU fans. These are just average movie-going people watching these things. Not one of them, Robert, not one of them mentioned the Avengers Endgame spot. The average movie-going audience, it seems, was not all that taken with the Avengers Endgame spot. Nobody was talking about it outside of our circles because my Twitter feed blew up. Like when the Avengers Endgame spot, my Twitter feed blew up, sure, but we're all in this same little circle. But I just found it really interesting that not a lot of other people were talking about it. Anyway, your overall impression. How do you think, number one, this movie played to the hardcore fans, or this trailer played to the hardcore fans? And number two, how do you think it played to the average movie-going audience?
Well, I'll tell you how it played for me. Like, I realized what it's going to be like to be an old man because I was going to have to need Depends because I about wet myself, just so you know. Infinity War made $2 billion.
Yes, it did.
Everything they show us from Endgame, that it's practically anything they show us with anybody, if there's any action at all, it's going to spoil something. They are marketing this movie, I think, beautifully. I mean, Captain America's in an encounter group session. He's at AA, whatever. They show the things in the trailer just, I'm like, oh my God, the world's gone to hell. You know, and everyone's, half the planet's gone, and they're playing that up. Now, anybody who saw Infinity War knows what they're getting into, you know. And well, I think you're right. I think that the people weren't blown away by it because it wasn't fantastically action packed or anything. They're playing it differently. They're giving us the whole. They can't tell us anything. So maybe people aren't remembering the trailer like we think they should. But if you're a fan, if you saw Infinity War, and $2 billion says a lot of people did. Anybody who saw Infinity War is going to love this trailer and talk about this trailer, as we are right now.
I'm going to disagree with you. I'm going to disagree with you wholeheartedly because when I, like, listening to three separate nationwide shows, and none of them, like, just all of them saw Infinity War, but none of them talked about this trailer. Now, you raised a point. You said you think they're handling the marketing this beautifully.
I do.
Understanding, no, they're not. What's the purpose of marketing? Getting people who aren't naturally coming to buy your product to get them motivated to come and buy your product. And guess what? The only people this spot appealed to were those of us who were already buying our tickets. That's it. It appealed to me because I squealed like a little girl when we saw Cap Shield. It appealed to you. But guess what? You and I are the two idiots that we're buying the tickets to this thing anyway. Do you know what this did not do? As a trailer, you just spent $2 million on one 30-second spot. I don't know that they convinced a single person who was either on the fence or wasn't just, you know, just by nature going to go and buy a ticket to this thing. I don't believe this spot motivated a single person to buy a ticket who wasn't already buying a ticket. And that is the only purpose for marketing. And it didn't do it. And I'll tell you what, as much as I love the trailer, And by the way, fact checker Jonathan brought up a great observation just before we started the show today. He goes, you know, one of the great things about this little spot was the fact that Thanos said, oh, wipe out half of everything and it's going to be a paradise. And Jonathan's point out, like you just said, the Earth didn't become a paradise. It became a hell on Earth. It became desolate and ruined and panic and chaos. And the world descended into depression and all this kind of stuff. It did not make the paradise that Thanos wanted it to be. And I thought that was a great observation. But to the emailer's point, I don't think you have to give things away. But you've got to convince the audience. This is the Super Bowl. You're there. You're putting it on the Super Bowl to appeal to this huge global audience to come buy tickets to this movie, and I don't think anybody who wasn't already gonna buy a ticket to the movie has been convinced otherwise from this spot, and I think it was a missed opportunity.
I don't know, man. We'll see how many people watch those YouTube posting and how many people comment. I think by not showing action or I think that's causing more of a stir. I know my Twitter exploded, social media exploded. I think they're playing this beautifully. I mean, I want Captain America to find his smile again.
Poor Captain.
That's what
America.
I do. I mean,
the only question I have for you is this. Do you believe that spot that they spent millions of dollars on as a piece of marketing motivated people who may not otherwise be buying tickets to go, damn, I'm going to go see that movie if they weren't already going to? Do you think it did that?
Okay. Here's the thing. It's a hard question to answer because I think if people haven't seen Infinity War, they're not going to go see Avengers Endgame anyway. I mean, it's not they're trying to get their audience, and watching that backlit silhouette shot of the Avengers, the remaining Avengers walking through
the Avengers
their Avengers headquarters, and you saw Rocket with them.
Yeah.
I'm like, dude, that's when I needed the Depends. That's when I needed the
Depends. I needed the Captain America.
I was going to wet myself, yeah. Man. I was going to wet myself. Luckily, I'm not incontinent yet, but it was amazing. I was like, oh my God, I don't think I've wanted to see a movie this bad since I wanted to see Empire Strikes Back when I was 13.
But you made your own point earlier. You didn't think they should put any trailers out.
I didn't.
Because you got all excited. That's great, but you were going to go anyway.
You
were
going to
go anyway, and so was I. And I squealed at the Captain America shield thing, but I guarantee half of America didn't know what that shot was. It was so tight. And it even took me a second or two to realize that was Cap's arm tightening the shield on, and I lost my freaking mind.
I don't know, man. If I was like 16 years old and I was watching the game, I would have run in and demanded my mom pre-buy me tickets on Fandango yesterday.
Yeah,
my mother would have been like, what movie do you want to see?
But you were going to do it anyway. I want to ask this thing. So, Ashley, so this trailer plays, this commercial plays, everybody's talking about it. Mm-hmm. Now, you are not the core, central, hardcore MCU fan. Did this trailer do anything to move the needle of your excitement from the movie? Is it the same? Is it less? Is it more? What did it do for you?
I'm not the core, but I have seen Infinity War. I have seen Civil War. I have seen Black Panther. I've seen a ton of these films. So I loved the trailer personally because it just felt like I liked how it was destitute and it felt like all was lost, but then by the end it felt like they were about to have a plan and tear shit up, and I was like ready to go in there with them, and I was excited. But I was sitting with a couple of friends for the Super Bowl and they could care less because they haven't really seen all the films, so it really felt like a trailer. It was like a to be continued. It was like a continuation trailer rather than a standalone film that they would just go see, and I don't think it is a standalone film. I think you have to see the movies before, so I'm not sure. Maybe it'll motivate people to see Infinity War, but they can't see Endgame without Infinity War. I mean, you kind of have to see the films.
$2.5 billion if this movie's good. $2.5 billion.
All I'm saying is, I think really the biggest takeaway from this was I was listening to a bunch of podcasts that were not movie related podcasts,
right.
Mm-hmm. And none of them even mentioned the Endgame. One mentioned the Toy Story one. None of them mentioned the Endgame one. And if you're Disney, that's not what you want to hear.
Yeah.
You just spent millions of dollars on this spot. You want everybody talking about it, and they failed to do it. And I just think it's a little bit of a missed opportunity. But it did move my needle. And clearly it moved yours.
Oh, it moved more than one of my needles, let me tell you. My needles were all about moving.